The second of the bronze medal bouts coming your way. Here we go, bronze medal action. Mariana Silva of Brazil, she's in blue. And Anika van Emden of Netherlands in white. They're ready to go. This is going to be tough. It's going to be tight. Let's get it on.
Van Emden is going to wait for her moment because she is going to play this tactically and just pick her off, I think. That's what's going to happen. Silva. She's obviously lifted by this amazing crowd. But Van Emden is a winner. Listen to that. They're really behind her, and it's a great atmosphere in here. Van Emden in, so did Sora Kamigoshi there. Hips across, went off the sleeve. So she opens up the account.
They are going to throw their bodies everywhere here. Nothing stays on the floor. You don't need any energy. The adrenaline will kick in to help you celebrate. Just use everything you've got. Van Emden has had it once, backs away. Now coming again, gripping up very high, almost getting her opponent in the face. And now in defense, Silva has a hold and tries to create the leverage with the leg. The sacrifice throw just didn't quite work. Referee will come in, not sure that she's got a hold there. No, she has not. Van Emden, third time lucky here to make the Olympic Games. She was a traveling reserve in Beijing, was the highest ranking athlete of her country in 2012, but was not selected. And then only last year she was involved in a drug scandal that threatened her position here in Rio in 2016. She survived that. Can she survive this? Sweeping with the leg, just trying so desperately hard. Both girls with their eyes focused on their feet, just trying to sweep the other, get one off balance. They only need an inch and they'll take a mile. That's how it works, particularly at this elite level. They've both got a good hold up top. The standing work is good. Going to ground, the Brazilian deliberately to try to get the hold and cannot do it. So Van Emden, she was involved in an investigation after missing a doping test. Officials came to administer the test. She was emerging from the sauna and unable to urinate, which resulted in an immediate ban and subsequent investigation. Within 2 months, she was cleared. It was called an administrative error. So my word, she deserves her place here. And you, well, even this Brazilian crowd wouldn't mind her getting a bronze, would they? Well, maybe they would.
Well, there's a score there. Van Emden just right in there. She did about three or four attacks and then straight in for the Sianagi, takes her over onto her side. So Van Emden now, she does deserve her place here, and she's fought so well, so hard on the world circuit, consistently a medal winner. Here she's fighting for one of the main prizes. So now Silva, Mariana Silva, she knows that she's got her work cut out here. Every technique that she does is being blocked by the left-hander from the Netherlands.
The crowd with plenty to say, and they know what they're talking about too. They love this sport of judo in this country and in this city.
Yeah, they do know, and they do appreciate good judo. They are just slightly biased towards their own, ever so slightly.
You think so? Oh, that's great. The energy is electric.
So now she's in again, this time on the right, this time Van Emden. Well, she's the one piling up the attacks. It's up to Silva to fire back.
Well, Silva moved to Japan for 2 years in 2008 at her own expense to help her make the national team. She was in London, finished 17th, and now so close to bronze, but also so close to time running out on her.
Just 37 seconds here. Van Emden just needs to carry on doing what she is doing, dominating the grips, attacking when she needs to. Silva looking for the opportunity here. Van Emden trying to stay in. Trying to stay in the area. And Silva give her a way out there. She attacked her. She went out the area, but Van Emden still gets it. Well, there's no consistency there with the edge plate whatsoever. I can't read that at all. And I can read most things.
Late charge from the Brazilian. She's keen. She'll rush out of here.
Yes, 4 seconds left, and Van Emden is going to win this bronze medal. It's all over. Van Emden gets the bronze. And Mariana Silva will be very, very disappointed with their so close semi-final that didn't quite go her way. And then now the bronze medal match.
Yeah, and that's double the despair, isn't it? You're in a semi-final only a matter of minutes ago, thinking that a chance for gold and glory that was seen here in this very stadium only 24 hours ago could be coming your way. She lost that, and now she's lost this. The young lady from Belo Horizonte, the sixth largest city in Brazil.
Yeah, it's from first to fifth in just a jiffy, isn't it? It really is. Doesn't take long.
Well, she'd been a Bella performer right throughout, but just not working towards the end. So congratulations to the Netherlands there, and a well-deserved medal to Anika van Emden from the Netherlands. As good as, or as sad, if you like, as this story is, and you can understand the despair there, the euphoria that van Emden must be going through right now is just as great, having worked so hard to make it to the Olympic Games. So the hometown hero was not to be, but the glory it is for the winner. And well, there's happiness in there somewhere. I was waiting for the smile. It'll come one day. That's just what it means. It's just pouring out of her.
Well, it does. It's full of emotion. That's what the Olympic Games is. It is. It, win or lose, it's emotional. And this is what led up to it. This little flurry of attacks here. Shoulder throw. Sianagi straight onto her side. That was the Yuko. That was what sealed it for Van Emden. Silva just had her hand all tied up there, and she went over for the score. Van Emden dominated the grips, though, I have to say, all the way through. So she was dictating the match, really. And then that last little flurry there, and coach says, yes, you've done the job.
Annika van Emden, she had to defeat the hometown hero from Brazil to get here, and she's going to enjoy this. Absolutely, the 29-year-old. Well, it's been a long path. She was a travelling reserve in 2008. And she did so much right today. A bronze medal now around her.